हाँ जी दिव्यांश, अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ, बोलो।
मैम एक बारी दोबारा करा देना मैम, न्यूलैंड
दोनों
के
बता देती हूँ, आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू, आई एम शेयरिंग द स्क्रीन, हैव अ लुक, देन आई विल डिस्कस साइड बाय साइड। वेट, we will see how it is and I will explain it again.
One, two, three.
Visible ho raha hai?
It was around the beginning of the 19th century that a famous German chemist attempted classic.
Yes, no, it's okay. Now you can see.
It was around the beginning of the 19th century that a famous German chemist attempted classification of the then known elements. It was none other than Johann Wolfgang Dobereiner who did so. He classified the elements known at that time in a particular manner. He placed them into groups having three elements each. Do you think these groups of three will have elements arranged randomly? Of course not. That's the unique way of placing these elements then. It's simple. Dobereiner arranged a set of three elements in such a way that the average of atomic mass of first and third element in the set gave him the atomic mass of the middle element. In simple words, the atomic mass of the second element will be approximately equal to the average of atomic masses of the first and the third element. Let's take an example to understand this better. One of the triads he suggested was that consisting of lithium, sodium, and potassium. The atomic mass of lithium is 6.9, while that of potassium is 39. So if you take their average, what would you get? Yes, you get 23, and 23 is the atomic mass of sodium. And this is exactly what Dobereiner had in mind when he framed the triads.
Is it clear? Yehi definition humne kari thi. कि व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन द इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक मासेस द मास ऑफ द मिडल एलिमेंट इज द एवरेज मतलब एवरेज एटॉमिक मास ऑफ द फर्स्ट एंड द थर्ड एलिमेंट ऊपर और नीचे तीनों एलिमेंट्स का एवरेज मीन निकालेंगे एंड दैट विल कम दैट इज द मास ऑफ द मिडल एलिमेंट ठीक है दिस वॉज गिवन बाय द डोबरेनर ठीक है इट वॉज गिवन ही गेव ओनली थ्री ट्रायड्स वन इज लिथियम सोडियम पोटाशियम नेक्स्ट जो था फ्लोरिन क्लोरिन ब्रोमिन वाला ठीक है एंड थर्ड इज बेरिलियम मैग्नीशियम वाला ठीक है जस्ट हैव अ लुक
हाउएवर दिस इज नॉट अ परफेक्ट मेथड ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन बिकॉज़ नॉट ऑल एलिमेंट्स फॉलो दिस प्रिंसिपल व्हेन अरेंज्ड इन ट्रायड्स आल्सो व्हेन डोबरेनर हैड पुट फॉर्थ द सिस्टम ओनली अ फ्यू एलिमेंट्स वर नोन टू हिम विद द डिस्कवरी ऑफ न्यूअर एलिमेंट्स दिस सिस्टम ऑफ ग्रुपिंग एलिमेंट्स डिड रियली वर्क आफ्टर ग्रुपिंग द एलिमेंट्स इन अ सीरीज ऑफ थ्री
जो आप कर चुके हो वन इज द एल्कली मेटल सेकेंड इज द एल्केलाइन अर्थ मेटल एंड थर्ड इज द हेलोजन ही गेव ओनली थ्री ट्रायड्स जितने एलिमेंट्स एट दैट टाइम द एलिमेंट्स वर डिस्कवर्ड इन दोज मतलब ही फॉलो ओनली मतलब ऑल द एलिमेंट्स वर डिस्कवर्ड ना 56 I think were discovered out of the 56 nine elements are following matlab the three triads are following this rule rest of they are not following so this was discarded after that the new matlab the scientist came with their own idea naturally when one scientist will do the sum of the experiment the others will naturally follow that one then Newland law of octave octave means eight theek hai he also follow the music pattern like the dhun jo hoti hai sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa sa again it comes on the eighth position means eighth jo hai note jo hai that is the repetition of the first note eighth element newland law of octave But it states that every eighth element is the repetition of the first element. Means when elements are arranged in a increasing atomic masses, mass of the eighth element or the properties of the eighth mass bhi nahi kahenge, properties of the eighth element is the repetition of the first element. ठीक है, देखो यहाँ पे अब.
Yes, this system was put forth by a new scientist named John Newland in the year 1866. There were around 56 elements that Newland could group. He simply arranged the elements in an increasing order of the atomic masses. At the end, he realized that these could be grouped such that every eighth element resembled the first. Astonishingly, the arrangement also stuck an analogy in his mind. Well, can you guess what analogy popped in Newland's mind? Let me help you with that. These are like octaves. Yes, octaves found in music. In case of octaves, we find that every eighth note is same as that of the first one. He found that every eighth element in the series resembles the first in various ways. This is how Newland arranged the elements in a table. For instance, as we can see here, if we consider lithium, then the eighth element after it would be sodium.
एक सेकेंड यहाँ पे देखो, ये देखो जो already we discussed ना, जो लिथियम है, दे आर शोइंग दैट द लिथियम इज हैविंग, जो सोडियम है लिथियम के नीचे, द सोडियम इज हैविंग द सेम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द लिथियम. ठीक है, ही अरेंज द एलिमेंट्स इन द इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक मासेस एंड ही ऑब्जर्व्ड वन पैटर्न दैट एवरी एट एलिमेंट इज द रेपिटेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट. अब व्हाई इट वॉज डिस्कार्डेड, बिकॉज इट वॉज एप्लीकेबल अप टू कैल्शियम ओनली. पहला ड्रॉबैक इनका ये था, इट वॉज एप्लीकेबल अप टू कैल्शियम ओनली. सेकेंड ड्रॉबैक इनका ये था, आफ्टर दैट ही सेड नो अदर एलिमेंट्स विल वुड बी डिस्कवर्ड. ठीक है, दैट वॉज ही गेव इज अजम्पशन कि नो एलिमेंट्स वुड बी डिस्कवर्ड. तो दैट वॉज द मेन ड्रॉबैक, बिकॉज ओनली 56 एलिमेंट्स वर डिस्कवर्ड एट दैट टाइम. एंड द थर्ड ड्रॉबैक यू कैन सी हियर, कोबाल्ट एंड निकल, यू कैन सी दिस कोबाल्ट एंड निकल, दे had put the two elements in one slot. एक ही slot के अंदर दो elements he kept. ठीक है, he kept the two elements in one slot. The main three demerits of the Newland law of octave was, one, it was applicable up to calcium only. Second, he assumed that the 56 elements जो है that were discovered, no elements would be discovered. And third, two elements kept in the one slot. ठीक है, आगे देखो.
The eighth element after it would be sodium. You would be amazed to know that they both share similar properties. Next, immediate examples would be that of beryllium and magnesium. Even these are positioned such that magnesium is 8 places away from beryllium. And yes, they both do resemble each other. With this, Newland named the grouping system of elements as laws of octaves and even Newland's laws of octaves. Although the arrangement pattern was quite good, but it was valid only until calcium and not applicable for elements after that. After calcium, every eighth element did not have properties similar to that of the first. By that time, there were only 56 elements known. Newland assumed that more elements will not be discovered in the future. Many elements were, of course, discovered later, but did not have properties that could fit in the system in any possible way. Another notable drawback in the system was that cobalt and nickel were placed in the same position. And this position was in the group of halogens like fluorine, chlorine, and bromine. But these halogens have completely different properties as compared to cobalt and nickel. With all these limitations, Newland's octaves also had to be ruled out. Later, there came a proper, well-defined system which was put forward by a famous Russian chemist called Mendeleev.
ठीक है.
He not only gave a system.
यहाँ तक किसी को doubt है? Anyone is having any doubt in these two, Dobriner or Newland law of octave? Now clear, Divyansh? Okay. Now after that, then another scientist came. That is Mendeleev. Russian scientist Mendeleev. ठीक है, इनका पूरा नाम था दमित्री इनोविच मेंडेलीव. दमित्री, यू कैन राइट दमित्री मेंडेलीव. ठीक है, ही गेव अ वेरी गुड मॉडल जिसको बाद में हमने फॉलो भी करा. ठीक है, रशियन केमिस्ट थे, ही वॉज अ रशियन केमिस्ट. एंड वट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द दिमित्री मेंडलीव, ही सेड द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर, वट इज द स्टेटमेंट, द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर, द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर पीरियोडिक फंक्शन, द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर पीरियोडिक फंक्शन ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मासेस, पीरियोडिक फंक्शन ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मासेस. ठीक है, और वी कैन राइट इन अ सिंपलर फॉर्म, हम इसको और सिंपल लैंग्वेज में वी कैन राइट कि व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन द, व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन देयर इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक मासेस, व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड, ठीक है, in their increasing atomic masses, ठीक है जी, same definition as we had followed in the Dobriner and well the Newland of octave, when the elements are increased in their increasing atomic masses, the element with similar chemical properties, the elements with similar chemical properties occurs at a regular interval of time, occurs at a regular interval of means jo property when the elements arranged increasing atomic masses, the mass of the the elements with the similar chemical properties occurs at a regular interval of time. Look here, ye bahut thoda sa hai, just have a look.
Systematic approach to classify elements.
It was a systematic approach.
The foundations of modern periodic classification that is widely used today. Let's have a detailed look at the periodic classification of elements as presented by Mendeleev in the next video.
ठीक है, मैं दिखाती हूँ. हाँ जी दिव्यांश, unmute yourself.
मैम एक बारी बोर्ड क्लियर दिखा दो मैम. बोर्ड नहीं दिख रहा.
दिखा रही हूँ. मैं Mendeleev भी एक मिनट दिखा दो.
ओके मैम. और मैम लास्ट लिमिटेशन बता दो एक बारी, न्यूलैंड लॉ ऑफ ऑक्टेव की.
न्यूलैंड लॉ ऑफ ऑक्टेव की क्या बताऊं दिव्यांश?
लिमिटेशन, थर्ड लिमिटेशन क्या थी?
कोबाल्ट एंड निकल, मतलब ही केप्ट द टू एलिमेंट्स इन वन स्लॉट.
नोटिस हाउ देयर इज नो फ्यूरल एड्स.
ही केप्ट टू एलिमेंट्स इन वन स्लॉट. दिव्यांश इज इट क्लियर बेटे? दिव्यांश क्लियर है बेटा? He kept two elements in one slot. First thi unki, it was applicable up to calcium only. Second, he assumed that no elements would be discovered in future. And third, he kept the two elements in the one slot. Or after keeping the one slot bhi chalo rakhe unhone, but upar the fluorine, chlorine or niche bromine. That means they are talking about the halogens. Halogens. They were talking about halogens. But cobalt and nickel, kisi bhi angle se, they are not halogens. ठीक है, तो इट वॉज द ग्रेट ड्रॉबैक. नाउ आफ्टर दैट Mendeleev, जस्ट हैव अ लुक, फिर उसके बाद समझाती हूँ दोबारा.
Dmitri Ivanovich Mendeleev played quite a legendary role in the field of chemistry. He not only gave us the simplest and the most efficient method of grouping elements.
56 elements known थे Dobriner में और Newland law of octave में. When Mendeleev came at that time, 63 elements were discovered. उस टाइम पे 63 एलिमेंट्स वर डिस्कवर्ड. मैं समझा देती हूँ पहले. when the 63 elements, what he did, he 63 elements ko he had written on the cards. उन्होंने कार्ड्स के ऊपर द करेक्टर्स ऑफ द 63 एलिमेंट्स ही हैड रिटन. ठीक है, आफ्टर राइटिंग लाइक द 63 एलिमेंट्स द सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टीज दे आर पुटिंग इनटू द सेम वन. मतलब 63 एलिमेंट्स व्हेन ही हैड रिटन ऑन द पेपर एंड कार्ड्स बनाए, कार्ड्स पे ही हैड रिटन एंड आफ्टर दैट ही इज अरेंजिंग दोज एलिमेंट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिमिलर केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी. दिस वॉज द डेफिनेशन कि व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन द इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक मासेस the elements with similar chemical properties occur at a regular interval of time. हर property मतलब element अपने एक regular interval के बाद उसके पास ही slot कर दिया उन्होंने कि where these are having the same properties. इतनी late join. हाँ जी, look.
But also laid the foundations of periodic classification of elements that we use today. So in this video, let's dedicate some time to understand what and how Mendeleev actually worked on. When Mendeleev began his work of grouping the elements and arranging them, there were almost 63 elements known to him. He was firm on the thought of arranging the elements with respect to their physical and less chemical properties. He knew that for understanding the chemical properties, he would need to make them react with one or two standard elements. For this, he chose hydrogen and oxygen. But why? Mendeleev thought of making the elements react with hydrogen and oxygen because of the following reason. They are very reactive, they are found readily, and they form compounds with most of the elements. Yes, this helped him understand the chemical properties of all the reacting elements. Later, in order to simplify the process, he wrote all the physical and chemical properties of each element on 63 different cards. Now, all he had to do is arrange these cards. But that wasn't so simple. So he started arranging the cards in the increasing order of their atomic masses. When he was done pasting all these cards on his wall, he had two astonishing observations. One was that there were a few empty spaces left in the complete table that he formed.
In your NCERT book, the Mendeleev periodic table was also given. The questions will come from that also, as in the video you had seen, ki they took the two characters, like the reactions dekhi unhone with the hydrogen and with the oxygen, because these are readily available and they can easily react. That's why he he observed the reaction between the different elements, ki what kind of the compound is formed. Theek hai? I will show you by making the Mendeleev periodic table. इन्होंने the फीचर देखो, when he was he arranged the 63 elements, then he observed some empty spaces between. ठीक है, he observed some empty spaces are there. ठीक है, जिसको उन्होंने बाद में दोबारा डिस्कस करा कि दीज विल बी डिस्कवर्ड लेटर ऑन इन फ्यूचर. ही केप्ट दोज एम्प्टी स्पेसेस एट इज एज इट इज. ठीक है, ही केप्ट इट, मतलब ही डिडेंट इंटरफेयर इन दैट वन, या ही डिडेंट अरेंज एनी अदर एलिमेंट इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वन. He told ki some of the elements will be discovered in future, those which are having the same properties of this one. Jaise unhone beech mein yahan pe jagah chhodi, to he said, he even told the even the atomic mass of the elements, ki koi aise elements bhi hain jiska ye atomic mass hai and it will be discovered in future, but he kept the left spaces between them. Look,
these positions belong to the elements that were not yet discovered. But Mendeleev had a firm belief that the missing elements did exist and are yet to be discovered. Not only this, but he was so confident about the characteristics of these elements that he predicted their properties well in advance. Later on, when the elements were discovered, it was found that the properties predicted by Mendeleev were almost a perfect match. Second observation that Mendeleev had was the recurrence of the physical and the chemical properties of these elements. When arranged in a systematic manner, it was found that the physical and the chemical properties of elements recurred at a particular interval of frequency. With this, Mendeleev came up with a law. He named it as the periodic law. The law stated that properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic masses. Now, what do we exactly mean by this? Let's simplify this by breaking the statement in parts. Properties of elements means the physical and the chemical properties of all the elements in the table. Orthoperiodic functions means those which occur at regular intervals. And lastly, of their atomic masses means when arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses. So can we simply say that when elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses, they show similarities in the physical and chemical properties at regular intervals? Yes, that's what Mendeleev meant. This is how Mendeleev laid the foundations for the modern periodic table.
Okay.
But did this great contribution by Mendeleev...
Now we will discuss ki how it occurred. Now I am just making that one, the periodic table, Dmitri Mendeleev, he gave the periodic table that is given in your NCERT book, and the questions will come from that one also. So just have a look. क्या था इनका periodic table? What he is told, he gave, when he gave his periodic table, at that time 7 periods and 8 groups were known. जब इन्होंने दिया था, then 7 periods and 8 groups. ठीक है जी? And 63 elements were discovered at that time. उस time पे 63 elements थे. He arranged the 63 elements in 7 periods and 8 groups. ठीक है जी? क्या था इनका? I'm just making here. It's given in your NCERT also. At least you have to see the pattern, which pattern they are showing. Right? Here they had taken the group and here yahan pe unhone liye periods. Theek hai? Oxides and hydrides. Group 1, group 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8th group. ठीक है? 8 groups he had given. इस side पे नीचे periods हैं and he gave the 8 groups. Look here, but he gave us, yahan pe he had given the formulas like R2O, theek hai, and RH, R2O and RH, theek hai, then RO, RH2, what does it indicate, theek hai, here R2O3, yahan pe kya tha, yahan pe periods hain, इस तरह से ठीक है पीरियड्स आर देयर यहां पे हाइड्रोजन आ गया सपोज मैं आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग वन एग्जांपल यहां थर्ड में हम लोग करते हैं एल्युमिनियम ठीक है यहां हम कर रहे हैं मान लो लिथियम या सोडियम फर्स्ट ग्रुप में राइट नाउ व्हेन ही स्टार्टेड एंड व्हेन ही ऑब्जर्व द रिएक्शन बिटवीन द एलिमेंट विद द ऑक्सीजन और हाइड्रोजन देखो लिथियम इट इज हैविंग अ वन वैलेंसी ऑक्सीजन इट इज हैविंग टू वैलेंसी देन व्हाट इज द फार्मूला Li2O यही बन रहा है यही बन रहा है R2O और जब हम हाइड्राइड के साथ करते हैं LiH सिमिलरली NaH या Na2O व्हेन आई एम टेकिंग द थर्ड ग्रुप में ले रही हूं तो एल्युमिनियम आया तो एल्युमिनियम हैविंग अ 3 वैलेंसी O हैविंग अ 2 वैलेंसी देन व्हाट इज द फार्मूला Al2O3 ठीक है तो दिस इज द फार्मूला R2O3 बन रहा है R2O3 ठीक है and similarly RH3 so R indicates the elements he observed कि when the elements are arranged in the 7 period and 8 group he observed the जैसे वहाँ पे अभी वीडियो में you had seen कि he took elements 2 elements के साथ he showed the reaction with the oxygen and with the hydrogen because these are easily available and he observed the same pattern कि जितने भी सेकंड ग्रुप में आएंगे दे विल फॉर्म द RO एंड RH2 थर्ड ग्रुप में R2O3 एंड RH3 मैंने आपको एक बना के भी दिखा दिया कि एल्युमिनियम दैट इज R R इज व्हाट एलिमेंट का नेम है व्हेन वी आर शोइंग द रिएक्शन विद द ऑक्सीजन एंड द हाइड्रोजन दे विल फॉलो द same pattern. That means when the elements are arranged in the increasing atomic masses, similar properties occurs at a regular interval of time. Any doubt?